Here to present his 2014 induction plaque is 2009 inductee Brett Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mike Modano.
Boy, wow. Thanks, Brett, for being here. And thanks, Billy, for choking up a little bit so I don't look like the only one out here going to be crying tonight. So, Brett, we had some great years together. Holly was a great teammate, great friend. And I would have had loved to have about 8-9 years with Brett Hall on my right wing. Kelly Massey, every time I come to these things, guys mentioned Kelly Massey's name, I'm like, who's Kelly Massey? And like Billy said, since the end of June, we've all got to know Kelly Massey pretty well. She's organized this whole weekend, and without her, she's the heartbeat of this whole Hall of Fame weekend. So our families, thank you. JD, Pat Quinn, who can't be here, we send our best to you. The entire Hall of Fame selection committee, thank you for this tremendous honor. It's been hard to put into words what this was going to mean, to be in the same room with some of the greatest players this sport has ever seen. I can tell you it's the most humbling experience I've ever been a part of. To Rob, Pete, Dom, you guys were three of the toughest guys I've ever had to play against. It was a privilege to play against you guys. And I hope in some weird way we've made each other better players for it. Billy Mack, you're one of the best refs out there in the game. Coming to me as an 18-year-old and telling me, Mike, quit whining out there, quit diving, don't embellish, work through all those hacks and slashes and hooks and whacks you're going to get, because newsflash is going to last a long time. So work through it. We'll give you the benefit of the doubt. And you've been a great friend, Bill. Thank you. And Lynn, I was this close to going to Hull and playing for Pat. I told you the other night, he would have been a great guy to play for. He was a great man, and the hockey world definitely misses him. I'm on a time crunch here, but two guys I want to mention for sure that made this possible for me to be here today. You saw him on the video, Rick Wilson and Bob Gainey. Rick called me in the summer of 86. I was 16 years old, just turned 16, and he asked if I wanted to come to Prince Albert and play hockey in Saskatchewan. I was like, I put my hand over the phone. I yelled at my mom. I said, go find a map to find out where Prince Albert, Saskatchewan is. All I know is in Canada somewhere. But at that point, it didn't really matter where it was. I was going as soon as I hung up the phone. So I packed my bags and left Detroit for PA. Rick coached me over the next 17 years in Prince Albert, Minnesota, and Dallas. I can't tell you how lucky I was to have a guy like Rick in my life, on and off the ice. So thank you, Rick, and thank you for being here tonight. The other is Bob Gainey. We had our moments early on in my career. We're a little like gas and water. We just didn't mix. He pushed me harder than anyone. Demanded a work ethic that I never knew existed. And he'd call me into his office dozens of times and say the same thing, Mike, we're never going to win the way you're playing. I was wondering what I'm doing wrong out there. He says, you need to be responsible in all areas of the game. And one of my favorite lines was, you need to become the hunter, not the hunted. I said, well, that went in one ear and out the other. I said, Bob's a pretty patient guy, and he needed to be with me. And after a couple years of beating that style into me, I finally went submissive and gave in. There were never guarantees it would work, but I trusted him and his vision. And there isn't a day that goes by that I'm not thankful Bob Gainey was in my life. And I'm asked all the time, by tons of people and media, one I'm most proud of in my career. And without a doubt, I can tell him I was lucky and fortunate and stayed healthy enough to play 22 years. 21 of them with the great organizations, Minnesota North Stars and Dallas Stars. And finally, Kenny Holland talking me in to go back for one more year in Detroit. But none of those years would be possible for some great owners, general managers, trainers, teammates, coaches. I had some great Dave Tippett, Doug Jarvis, and of course, I got to say the great Ken Hitchcock told me to say that, who eventually led us to a Stanley Cup in 1999 in Dallas. Being able to bring hockey and eventually a Stanley Cup to Dallas and the state of Texas is something I'll cherish forever. And the great fans of Minnesota, Dallas, and Detroit, for your support over the years, we couldn't have done it without you guys. And something great happened this summer. July 10th, my wife gave birth to twins, Jack and Kate. But as soon as I saw him, I wanted to call my mom and dad and apologize for being the constant headaches I gave them throughout the years. I never truly knew how much they loved me until that moment. But mom and dad, I want you to know how much I love you. Thank you for all your sacrifices you made for me to play hockey. The early morning practices on the weekend when dad was off work, having to buy hockey gear every year because I was outgrowing it. Countless hours on the road, traveling to hockey tournaments, many of them going up and down the 401 from Detroit to Toronto. And mom, you made the best ice and the smoothest ice in town in the backyard. And you were never afraid to grab the garbage can and get in the net when we needed a goalie. Those moments I'll never forget. You both were with me every step of the way. I couldn't be who I am if I wasn't for you. And I hope to be half the parent you were to me with both Jack and Kate. And finally, to my wife, Allison, can't believe how lucky I got to have found you. And that you said marry into an old, washed-up, retired hockey player. You're the beauty and the brains of this family. Thank you for allowing me to be in your life. To our babies, Jack and Kate, you're the best two things that ever happened to me. So you know, you may not know it now, but someday we might come back and you'll have evidence that Dad actually played in the NHL. But today my dreams came true. And one day yours guys will too. I promise to be there every way, step of the way my parents were with me. I love you both more than you'll ever know. Finally, I just want to thank you all for being here. Again, the committee, my fans, my organizations I had to play with. I had some great teammates, again, my friends, my family. Thank you all.